Fire! Welcome! Well, it's one of my favourite days to be a record collector today because it's box set day. And look what I've got here. This pretty big behemoth. Not quite as heavy as I thought it'd be. Judging from the size and shape of this, I think you're going to know that there is records in this box set. Actually, this is a mixed media set. And it's replacing something that I've already got, but just with a certain extra. It'll all become clear as I get this open. This is from a Discogs seller in Germany. Now then, I thought I was getting a good price initially. I can't remember the exact price. I made a best offer. I was a little bit gutless with it. I didn't go too low what the listing was because I really wanted this and I just didn't want to miss out and then have to pay full price either from this seller or from a different one. But he accepted my best offer and there was no taxes to pay, but I think that was because it was over a certain value. And then I got a letter from Parcel Force the other day hitting me with a £39 customs charge for this. I think all in all, including customs and the international postage that I paid up front when I paid for the actual box set, this was probably between £170 and £180, which I still think is a pretty good deal for this because it's pretty rare now. It's been out a few years, not loads, but it's not exactly new either. And I've seen it going on Discogs and eBay for between £200 to £300. So I'm happy to get it. I'm used to paying the customs and the taxes up front on Discogs for European purchases, but for some reason, probably because of the value of this, I had to pay them afterwards. Right then, enough of that, let's get to the exciting stuff. So I'm in my opening heavy boxers position here, which really isn't that good, and the sensible thing would have been perhaps to at least cut this box open before I get started, but I've just made a one slit at the top look, and I think I might be able to slide everything out. Oh, you can see some German newspaper there. Don't know why I like it when international sellers use their own country's newspaper as packing material. A, it's good for the environment because it's like a form of recycling. And B, I just like seeing foreign stuff. Yeah, get that out carefully. Also came with some extra cardboard in the middle. So I think the packing job here has been excellent. This box set was classed as near mint, but it had been opened. Apparently one of the vinyl records in here is still sealed. I mean, it didn't matter to me whether it was brand new or used, as long as it was in the condition that I would expect such a premium set to be in. Right then, what have we got? Ah, marvellous. We've got the Super Deluxe Paris box set from Rammstein. So this was their Paris concert that was, I'm trying to think of the year of this, maybe about 2017, 2018. I'll put the right year down on screen, no doubt. It actually got a limited theatre release, the concert did. I think it was the Swedish director Jonas Åkerlund who directed it. He's done a lot of Rammstein's promo videos. I remember a lot of fans at the time weren't that happy with Paris. They said the direction was a bit odd and there was too many cuts and stuff. I personally thought they were just being nitpicky when I watched it, because obviously, as I say, I do already own this in a rather less deluxe format. I thought it was great, but maybe I'm easily pleased. You can no doubt guess the addition to the standard Blu-ray and CDs that are in here, given the 12 by 12 inch size of this box. I like the silver and black motif on the front and the back. We've got a little bit of blue there as well. Got a nice sort of industrialized image of the Eiffel Tower there. Gives you the track listing on the back. Yeah, I'm happy with the condition of the box so far. I mean, it'll be a bit annoying if I open this, and yes, we are going to open it and take a look at the items. It'll be annoying if I open it and there's stuff missing, but I trust most Discog sellers. You know, you only have to look at their feedback ratings, really, to see whether someone's worth shopping with or not, and I've had overwhelmingly positive results on Discogs Marketplace. Let's get this open and look at each item. So there's your lid there, sort of not exactly premium cardboard backing, but nice enough. Oh, now we've started with a nice image of Till Lindemann here. So this is going to be one of the, or maybe even two actually, as it's a gatefold sleeve look, two of the LP discs for the Paris gig. So Till Lindemann on the front there, then we open it out, we see Flarker and Ollie, I think that is, in the middle of the gatefold. So this is going to be discs 1 and 2. So this is basically why I got this Paris set again, because I wanted the album and LP. Nice inner, but what about the disc? Ooh, it's a nice bold blue. Lovely stuff there. And I believe the other discs, they're all blue as well, so there's no point looking at them all. Perhaps I'll show you disc 2 just to confirm so. But as I say, the other LP set in here is actually sealed. Yeah, same look. So here's the other half of the Paris concert, and as you can see, it is still sealed. I'm not going to unseal this now. I will obviously be doing that when I listen to the LP. You know, I've heard the CD, I've watched the Blu-ray, and I will watch the Blu-ray again. I want to hear this on actual analog vinyl. There's Christoph Schneider on the front of discs 3 and 4. So this obviously came out a couple of years or so before their untitled album in 2019. There's going to be no sort of new or post-2019 songs on this album, this set. Right then, I'm getting this last bit out. Oh, I'll just quickly show you the bottom. Quite a nice black cardboard backing. It's got one of those handy ribbons where you can insert it where you want, so it's easy to get stuff out. This feels very much, it's the wrong shape, but it feels like the sort of annuals you'd get as a kid at Christmas. It's got that sort of annual hardback book feel to it. But there should be CDs and Blu-rays in here. Yes, there is. Oh, I do like how they've done this. So I think that's your two CDs on top, which is the same as all the music on the 4 vinyl records. And then that disc there is the Blu-ray. And that's your lot for that. But I'm really happy with this. Kind of wish I'd got this years ago, even though I wasn't collecting vinyl records until, 2019? And this would have come out probably a couple of years before that. I may have been able to get it at a more reasonable price. I think this was always quite expensive. I don't think you would have ever got much change out of $150 for it. And like I say, with all the fees and extra costs for me, this was probably 170 odd, maybe getting on to 180, but I'm happy with this. Rammstein Paris, the Super Deluxe LP, Blu-ray and CD box set. Now, I did say that I'd already owned this, and to prove that, here we are. This is the standard, I say standard, one of a few different multi-formats, but this is the Blu-ray and CD version. I will have shown this on the channel before in previous videos looking at my Rammstein collection. What am I going to do with this? Because I don't need this now. The Blu-ray and the CDs are exactly the same. I just wanted this box set because A, I love box sets, and B, I wanted the Paris live album on vinyl. I think I've got a good idea who I can send this to for an act of kindness. So someone may be getting this in the post very soon. I just like to pass things on, particularly duplicates and stuff that I don't necessarily need anymore. But here's the star of the show today. Paris by Rammstein. Really nice set. Pricey, but a real collector's piece there. And goes really nice in my Rammstein collection that obviously is long time and regular viewers know. I've been bumping up all the vinyl record aspect to that collection over the past few months. So thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed this look at this Super Deluxe box set. I want to say special thanks, as I always do, to my wonderful subscribers and generous patrons. Please see my Patreon link, Facebook group link, and a link for Urban Jungle Contents Insurance down in the description below. I'm going to go now, and what else, but I'm going to put Paris on the record player, so hear it on vinyl for the very first time. Kind of completes the sort of Rammstein vinyl albums collection for me, this. There's no other of their albums, certainly, that have come out on actual LP. It's a bit of a hole filler, this, as well as being just sort of a fancy collector's box set. There's still Rammstein Record Store Day, very limited singles that I know I'm never going to get because the prices are just absolutely astronomical. But anyway, I'm going to go away and listen to this, and I do hope that you all join me again, and it won't be too long either, for my next box set unboxing and record and music collecting video. Cheers, everyone. See ya!